हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय सेल्फ राकेश अंजन श्रीवास्तव, सांस्कृतिक गणेश यूनिवर्सिटी। आई टीच यू चैप्टर टिश्यू फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास टू। आई न्यू चैप्टर टिश्यू इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी ऑल स्टडी अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन एंड ऑल्सो प्लांट टिश्यू। एंड इन प्लांट टिश्यू द सेकेंड पार्ट द कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू वी ऑल स्टडी। कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू एंड स्टार्टिंग योर स्टडी अबाउट सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू। देयर आर सम डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन सिंपल एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू। सिंपल टिश्यू ऑल्सो मेड फ्रॉम सेम टाइप ऑफ सेल्स एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू इंक्लूडिंग वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ सेल्स एंड देयरफॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू। एंड ऑल्सो इन प्लांट कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू आर ऑफ टाइप्स, जाइलम टिश्यू एंड सेकेंड इज फॉर फ्लोएम टिश्यू। जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम बोथ आर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू एंड प्रेजेंट इन प्लांट एंड दे आर कॉल्ड कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यू। जाइलम टिश्यू द फंक्शन ऑफ जाइलम टिश्यू ट्रांसपोर्टिंग वाटर एंड मिनरल्स, वाटर एंड फ्रॉम सॉइल बाय द हेल्प ऑफ रूट टू अपर लेयर ऑफ प्लांट। इट मींस ऑल पार्ट ऑफ प्लांट वाटर एंड मिनरल सप्लाई बाय द हेल्प ऑफ जाइलम टिश्यू। And phloem tissue, they are also called conductive tissue. They supply food to all parts of plant body. We have important work of xylem and phloem tissue. Xylem transporting water and minerals and also phloem tissue transport food to all part of the body. Now one by one in details we have to know about xylem and phloem tissue. At first about xylem tissue. Xylem tissue is tube like structure and also called conducting tissue, and they made from four types of cells. First is called tracheus. Second is called vessels. And third is called xylem, parenchyma. And fourth is called xylem. So four types of cell form the xylem tissue, and their functions are also different. So it is called complex permanent tissue. At first, tracheae and vessels. They are tube-like structures, and in these four types of cell, only xylem parenchyma is large cell, and rest are dead cells. A, B, C, D, it means tracheae, vessels and xylem fibers are dead cells. And this cell, this xylem tissue made from three types of dead cell and one live cell. It means xylem parenchyma is only live cell. All are dead cells. Now tracheae, they are also hard based thick layer structure and also tubular structure and also open cavity present inside it. It means inside it vacuum or whole cavity are open, and in this cavity because they made from dead cells, so this cavity also open. and space present inside it. And vessels are catastrophic and they are also tubular structure. And the conduction of water and minerals occur by the help of vessels. It means both are attached to each other and also tubular structure. They live from dead cell. So this is always vacant inside it, this cavity. And vessels are also tubular structure attached to it and also help in conduction of water and mineral to all part of the plant body. Now xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma made from parenchymatous cell. Parenchymatous cells help in the formation of xylem parenchyma. They are also live cells and also they are supporting in nature and also storing food, helping storage of food. The most important function of it is storage of food. And second, side wind conduction. Side wind conduction. Of water and mineral. It means various types of branches also present in the plant. So in this cyclic conduction of water and minerals conducted by parenchyma, xylem parenchyma, and they also help in storage of food materials. Now xylem fiber, they are supporting in nature. It means the first complex permanent is to xylem, including various types of cells and their function are also different. But all work only for the conduction of water and minerals in the xylem. Now next complex permanent tissue, phloem. We are study about phloem tissue. It also helps in the conduction of food inside whole part of body. Leaves prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis and after then transporting in each and every part of the plant body by the help of phloem tissue. So for this work, this phloem tissue also made from four types of cells. First, sieve tube. Second, companion cell. Phloem parenchyma. And fourth, phloem fibers. In this phloem tissue, all are live cells. Sieve tube, live cell. This is also live cell. And this is also live cell. One dead cell. In this way, we are studying about xylem. Only xylem parenchyma live cell, but in phloem tissue, maximum are live cell. Only xylem phloem fibers are dead cell. Sieve tube and companion cells. Both are tubular structure and also help in the transporting of food material. And phloem parenchyma, they also help in the storage of food materials they provide mechanical support to the all the other parts of this phloem tissue. And phloem fibers present in it, they are also dead cell and also provide mechanical support to the phloem tissue. In this way, we all study about xylem and phloem tissue. Both are conducting, but xylem conduct only water and minerals, and phloem conduct food materials and also important part of the plant. In this way, we all study about different types of plant tissue. In the first portion, and in plant tissue, simple permanent tissue and also complex permanent tissue. And in the starting, we all study about growth tissue called permanent tissue. Now, I complete this portion, it means about plant tissue and also all the students try to write notes about plant tissue. Some topics are important in this. Explain about, first question is, explain about meristematic tissue and their function. And also second question, prove by experiment. Growth tissue present in only some special parts of the plant, not explained in all part of the plant. And also parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Write short notes about this. And also what are complex permanent tissue and explain about xylem and phloem tissue. Now I complete this part.